So today topic is about like AI adventures with AutoML, auto machine learning. So today we are going to talk about like Google Cloud AutoML. So how many of you like are machine learning experts or who is learning the machine learning? Okay, yeah, a couple of them. So, but I'm going to start from like from the scratch. This is like the way I have learned. So I'm going to explain like how I learned and how easily we can understand the machine learning. So the agenda of the session is I'm going to give a machine learning overview and then the different machine learning offerings that is provided by Google Cloud Platform. And then we are going to deeply discuss about Google's AutoML, how to prepare the training data set and how to upload that image and how to read that metrics that's coming back from that model and all. And followed by a short demo. The demo is using like a computer vision or AutoML vision to classify my daughter toys here. Yeah. So I'm Siva. He already introduced me. I'm Siva, working as architect in CEI, Computer Enterprise Inc. And I'm mostly working on like developing cloud, mobile, and IoT solutions. Recently, I'm picking up interest in these kind of machine learning and artificial intelligence solutions as well. And I'm from Orlando only. You can reach me at my Twitter, at ksivamuthu. And she is my daughter, 2 years old. So I brought her toys for demoing you guys. So let's start with the machine learning overview. What's the hype about machine learning, right? So machine learning is like everywhere. In Google I/O 2018, there is a drink game like you can get a shot if someone says machine learning. So it's kind of like that much hype this is giving for that machine learning. So what's machine learning? Let's start with that artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is like a science of getting machines to do certain things, specifically like a human-like capabilities such as seeing and hearing and doing conversation, like they do in the movies, right? In the movies, most of the machines like they will converse with each other and they will vision something and they'll do like extraordinary stuff. So that's the initial point, right? So that imagination is bringing this artificial intelligence as a science to get machines to do certain things. And obviously, to do certain things, we need to learn, right? For human, to do certain things, we are learning, continuously learning. So in the same way, if machine needs to do certain things, then the machine needs to learn. So that's a science that came from AI. So machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. It's science of like getting computers to act without being explicitly programmed. What does that mean is, the machine needs to learn by its own self. It should not be like programmed by someone. In traditional programming, what it would happen is like to add some two numbers, then we are explicitly programming the machine, like get the input number one, get the input number two, and add two numbers and give the output, right? In traditional programming, that's the traditional way. We are giving input and we are giving algorithm to generate the output. Then the machine will get the input and based on the algorithm we have written, it's giving that output. That's right. But in the machine learning, it's in like a different way, different perspective. In the machine learning, what's happening is we are giving the input and also we are giving the output. We are not generating like any algorithm to match like, hey, give the output or something like that. It's not the traditional programming. It's a machine learning programming. Since it's learning, it should learn by its own self. It's not like a feeding something to machine. So we are giving input and output. Say like, hey, these are the inputs and these are the expected outputs. Can you give me an algorithm so that like if I give any other input, you can give like the similar output which I am expecting based on the previous data or previous experience. So that's a kind of like a machine learning. And there is like another subset in machine learning that is called deep learning. So what is deep learning is like the same machine learning, the machine is learning continuously, but it's based on the deep neural network, which is similar to like how our brain neural network works. So how our brain neural network works is like it's based on the neuron communication between the neurons. The same way the deep neural network is also working. It's like communication between all those neuron slots so that like it's going forward to like a predictor, higher accuracy models. So those are the three terms which we have to like we have to learn, like artificial intelligence, machine learning, and the deep learning. And there are like three different types of machine learning. There are like a lot of types, but these are the three major types of machine learning. Supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. So what is supervised learning is, we are giving the data set, and we are labeling the data set. For example, cat or dog images. We are giving that both cat and dog image sets, and we are labeling like these images are cats, and these images are dogs. Then the machine will train an algorithm to classify between cats and dogs. That's kind of like a supervised learning because we are labeling the data set. But in the unsupervised learning, the machine itself will learn and find the common factors and try to like form the clusters or grouping based on like the common factors. What does that mean is like if I'm uploading image and I didn't do any label, so it's like unlabeled data set, then what it's really doing is it's trying to find like common shapes, for example, square, triangle, then I'm uploading like circle. So it's trying to find out like the common characteristic between those images. Then it will try to do the clustering stuff or the grouping stuff. It's not only the images, there are like multiple structured, unstructured data, so you can like do those machine learning algorithm. Then the third one is the reinforcement learning. Reinforcement learning is like it's nothing based on the data set. Once the image is uploaded and the machine predicts correctly, then we are avoiding that program. If machines predict like wrongly, then we are like punishing that program. So based on that, like the award and the punishment, the machine itself, it's learning. It's based on like a reinforcement learning. So that's why like I put that the reinforcement dog scenario. So we are continuously like award punishes. So even if we didn't award or punish, then the machine will improve its accuracy to predict like the accurate results. Then we are going to deep learning, right? So what is deep learning? So I have already told before like deep learning is based on machine learning, but it's with a deep neural network, right? So I'm not going to dissect the brain and this is how the brain communication works or this is how the neurons communicate and all. But in short, the machines will learn the same way humans do, right? It's not based on like, rephrase my word. So all that brain network and communication between the neurons, communication between the neural network and all, it's finally going to be like how the humans, we are learning. It's not like the complex stuff. It's maybe like it's based on algorithm and other criteria coming in, but the overall view, it's based on like how humans are learning, right? So let's do like a simple exercise. So I'm going to show like a couple of pictures and going to like give an exercise like how we are predicting the images and all. Capture that flow, the same flow we are going to do for like the machine learning approach itself, right? So let's do an exercise on like a human learning to understand machine learning. So I'm going to show you an image, someone holding an apple, and also I'm going to introduce a word called virsat, right? So what does that virsat mean? So what would you guess the word virsat mean? It may be like a holding hand, or it may be apple, or it may be food. And how confident are you in like a next guess? If I show the next image, are you confident like you can say whether it's virsat or not? Because we are having like less training data. We just see like one picture, right? So we are coming to the conclusion like this virsat mean like anything in this object. It may be holding hand or apple or food, or even I can say like some other stuff, right? But if I show you like a gallery of picture, and if I'm saying all these images is belong to the category called virsat, then what will you, what did you guess for like the word virsat means? Yeah, that's right. So how did you come to that conclusion? Yeah, you were like you were seeing like the previous experience. You see that apple. Then when you see this picture, you are getting like the common characteristic. But two steps you are doing. One is you are trying to find the common characteristic, generalization. So you are trying to find like the common factors. The other thing is you are removing all that the previous guesses, which is not in that case. For example, the holding hand. This coffee is also having holding hand. But you are removing that because the other images doesn't have that holding hand, right? So you are doing like removing that the previous learning, basically like unlearning and learning new things. So this is the two steps that's involved in that machine learning. So now if I show the image, which is you have not seen before, now if I ask the question like whether it's Virsat or not, then you can say like it's Virsat because it's red in color, right? And anyone know like what does that Virsat means? Okay, Virsat is like a fictional language. It's actually red in color. Virsat is like a fictional language for like the Game of Thrones. So in the Game of Thrones, there is a language, fictional language. I forgot the name, Dothraki or something. So yeah, in the Dothraki, Virsat means red. So that's why like I have put that there. So now go back to this deep learning, but we will see it in like a little bit how it's actually working in the real way. So the same way, like we are having like a bunch of images. This is based on like a face recognition algorithm. So this face, we are having input layer and output layer, and there are like a lot of hidden layers in between. So input layer is getting all those images, and it's doing like a initial stuff that is based on like patterns of local contrast. Then once it's identified, then it's going to that, it's the same approach. It's unlearning few things, and it's learning few things, and it's going towards like a strong algorithm. So it's next it's checking like face features, next it's checking like more data. Then based on the features, then it's coming to this output layer, right? So same approach as we have learned, unlearn few things, learn few things. It's like a good life lesson, right? So we have to do the same thing for deep learning. But what if like a data is more complicated? For example, cat and dog is fine because it's a single object image. But if you are having like more features in the image, then what it's happening is this what happened. We need to go deeper. We need to go deeper in like a neural networks. We need to add like more layers. This is my question. We need to add more layers, and that will go into that the deeper learning. So, is everyone okay? Is it a good thing? Yep. Now let's talk about like the Google AI building blocks. This is our second part in our agenda. So, to do the machine learning thing. Machine learning is like not a deep rocket science, right? For example, like if you want to implement the machine learning, it's not like, for example, I have like automobile industry. Implementing the machine learning in my industry, it's not like, okay, I'm going to do some teleportation stuff or travel to space or something. It's not like that much complex. So that's why like Google and other providers, they are giving machine learning very easy way as an API. To developers, so that the developers can implement it in their application in the very simple way. It's not like the complex one, very simple way. So there are we are going to see like what are the different machine learning offerings that is provided by Google, and like AutoML. So there are like a spectrum of artificial intelligence building blocks. In the left hand side, you can see like a machine learning APIs. It's a simple REST API. You can call that REST API and do all those machine learning algorithms or machine learning tasks, such as like labeling the image or face detection or emotion recognition or like extract that sentiment from the text. So those kind of the common problems and the common solutions that is already pre-trained by Google, and that model is already available in REST API. So that is for developers. They can easily like integrate with the machine learning APIs and all. But on the right hand side, like it's for data scientists and practitioners. They want to own the custom model. They want to do their custom models, and they want to do like a deep learning architecture and all. For that, Google is providing like infrastructure. including Cloud ML Engine and Deep Learning VMs. So using those ML Engine and VMs, you can write your model using like a TensorFlow or Scikit. You can write your model architecture and the algorithm, those things, and run those in deep learning VMs or ML engine. So the infrastructure is handled by Google. But what happens like if application developers, they need to develop a custom model for their domain, right? So that's where the AutoML comes into the picture. So as I have told before, like machine learning APIs, it's simple integration. Cloud ML engine, it's for machine learning expert, it's not for developers with less machine learning expertise. And if I want to develop a custom model, then the AutoML comes into handy. So let's start like looking the models one by one, right? So machine learning models, there are like a different products that is available in the machine learning APIs. This is easy to integrate. You can create a API key, you can integrate in your application. So Cloud Vision, which is doing like the logo detection and landmark recognition, face detection, those kind of objects. And the Cloud Speech, it's doing like a speech to text and text to speech conversion. And Cloud Natural Language, it extracts the entities and it's doing like a sentiment analysis on the text and all. This can be used for like, whether a user review is happy or not, right? So once a user reviews, then we can identify the sentiment of the text. Okay, this user is really happy. So those kind of sentiment analysis we can do using natural language. And then we are having video intelligence. So this video intelligence is like, you can take the video, and this video intelligence API will extract the frame and find the object in that video. For example, if a video has like some animals playing, or if I am playing in like a beach, then if I am searching like beach, then you can see like the videos and images that contains beach. That's how like the Google images are all working. So in the Google images, you can go and search that text, then it's giving like all the pictures, videos that has that object in there. And Cloud Translation, you can do translation like more than 200 languages. So these are that we have discussed in high level, landmarks, product search, OCR and all. Okay, so this is what we discussed, right? But what if our data has like belongs to a certain domain and we need to support our own custom models or the concepts? So to create the ML model, there are like a couple of steps belong to this ML model. It's not like AutoML, it's like a purely based on like how to create a ML model. So to create a ML model, we need data pre-processing, we need to collect the data, and we need to create the data in like a different data sets and all. And so for that, like what are the pre-processing techniques should I use? And for ML model design and tune model parameters, like what are the modeling techniques and what are the deep learning architecture and what set of hyperparameters? And in case of evaluate, how do I know my model's performance? Once a model is trained, how I can accurately know like whether this model is performing well or not? And how can I improve my data set and what metrics are most important? So these are the questions that's coming when we are trying to create a ML model. And to deploy, how infrastructure is like serve my model at like a scalable level, and how it's going to serve the latency issues and all. So you see, right, to create the ML model, there are like a bunch of questions and there are a bunch of steps. And if there is new data added to this existing model, then you need to do the same steps again, right? For example, once you have deployed and update, you are seeing like a new set of data that's coming into that model. Then you need to do the same step again, like do the ML model design and do that model parameter tuning and all those stuff. So think about like the cost and effort it's it takes, right? So for that, Google introduces like a Cloud AutoML. So basically like AutoML automates all that complex stuff. It's like a developer friendly, so anyone can like upload their images and their data sets, and all those model tuning and parameter tuning and the infrastructure, all this taken care of by Google. And also like the model quality, that's like the high quality. I will explain like how the model quality works. But how AutoML works, the same way like I have told already, we need to upload the image data set, and AutoML take care of like a training, deploying, and serving that model, and you can generate the predictions through REST API. So there are like three different AutoML products: AutoML Vision, AutoML Natural Language, and AutoML Translation. Today we are going to see only AutoML Vision, but there are like other products also, like Natural Language and Translation. So how AutoML is giving that much high quality training without we are tuning any parameters or something, right? So AutoML is having like an AI agent, artificial intelligence agent, that's basically like it's building a high quality deep learning model by its own. So it's getting all those data sets. It analyzes that image, and it's extracting the features, different features, and it tries to build that. It tries like a different machine learning algorithms, and it finally find it like a high optimized algorithm to give like a high predictions. So everything is happening like a behind the scenes from the AutoML. From the developer perspective, we are uploading the image, and we are probably like giving a couple of different sets. Then the machine learning is, the AutoML is taking care of all those high quality training. And if you upload like a new data set, then it adjusts its own model parameter and all, then it's updating its algorithm, and it's giving like a new model, pre-trained model. So these things, we talked about, the only thing is like integration with the human labeling. There is a human labeling service. So if you don't want to like label your image data sets, then there is like a human image labeling service that that party will do like a human image labeling. So let's do the demo, right? So let's, done with the theory, and let's do the demo. Starting with a simple scenario. I'm not going to do like the more extensive scenario and all. I'm going to start with simple scenario because this is way like we have to learn how to do those things and what are the parameters. So I'm going to build an application to classify my daughter toys. So I have like four toys: bear, cow, duck, and a dog. So I'm going to build an application to classify these toys. So to prepare the training data, I will go to this AutoML Vision thing. So you need to create a data set. So here you can create a data set, and you can provide the data set name, anything. For example, here like a magical toys or something. And there are like a couple of ways to import. You can import like from your computer, and also like you can import from the CSV file. That CSV file contains like a list of images that contains in that's in the Google Cloud storage directory. So you can upload all your images in Google Cloud storage and give all the list of URLs in that image in the CSV. And the second column would be like the label of the image. So you can give like what label it belongs to. Then you can upload. Then that upload will also work. And also like you can use the REST API or the SDK that is provided by Google AutoML Vision to do this importing images programmatically. And there is like a classification type to enable the multi-label classification or single-label classification. What does that mean is, if it is a single-label classification, if I'm having an image, then image that's contained to only one category, right? If it is like a multi-label, then that image maybe belong to like a different categories. For example, let's say like a natural language sentiment analysis, right? If it is happy, then I can say like, okay, this text contains only that happy emotion. But if I'm saying like happy and excited the same way, then I can say like happy and excited for the same text. So it's going to be like the multi-label classification. So that's how we need to create this data set. I have already created like a bunch of data sets here. One of the data set is like a DevFest Florida toys. So in this, there is like a four tab. The images, this is where we are uploading like the training image data set. And train, to train like the machine learning model, evaluate and predict. So for that images, if you upload like a new image, that would be like an unlabeled category. So here I have created like a bear, cow, dog, and duck, the four labels. And I uploaded like a different bear images and different duck images and labeled them as such. So here like I have uploaded all duck images and labeled as a duck. And there is like a best practice in AutoML. That is, you need to create the none of the above exactly in the same way, like a none underscore of underscore the above. So this is like, for example, you are doing like a toys classification, but you need to identify like the edge case scenario. For example, if I am trying to predict like the toy, which is not in the toy list, then you have to train this machine learning model so that like in the none of the above, I have uploaded like the other categories, which is not belong to these four labels. So this will give like a little bit high accuracy because you are saying to the machine like, okay, this is the four labels I am trying to look at. If anything comes out of that four label, then don't do classification. Don't try to do this classification, right? So that's one of the best practices which is mentioned in the Google Docs. You need to add this none of the above label. And once the image data set is uploaded, you need to train the model. So here I have trained like a bunch of models, but you need to train the model. And in the train model, you have this training budget. So what does the training budget means, right? So it's based on like the computing hour. So if you have like more than 1,000 images in your data set, then you can do like more than 1 hour compute training. So how much more you are doing based on your image features, then it will be giving like more high predictions. For example, here like I'm using less than 1,000, so one compute hour is fine. But if you have like complex images and complex things to do, it's based on like how deep we are going into that neural network. So you can increase your compute hour, and that will give like the more high accuracy. And once a model is trained, you can see like the models. I have trained like more models. I have added like three images here, and I did like a lot of things. Initially, I started with 40 images. Then I fine-tuned the model and showing like now it's 114 images. So it's once a model is trained, you can read the metrics. So if you click the evaluate tab, you can select the model and you can read the metrics. So here like the precision and the recall. So the precision is based on like it's giving how much so high precision, it's giving like a fewer false positive. So before that, like what does that false positive, false negative means? Like for example, the same toys, duck, right? If I am having like another image and that is recognized as a duck, then that's called false positive. And if I'm uploading the duck image, but it's not recognized as a duck, it's giving like some other thing, or it's saying like none of the above, then the false negative, right? So these two things need to be reduced. So to see that the model graph, you can see like the precision and the recall graph. Here, you can see like the individual thing. What are the true positives and what are the true negatives it's giving. And also the other thing is there is a confusion matrix. So this confusion matrix is based on like the true label and the predicted images. So the true label and the predicted images should be like match. It's not like exactly 100%. It may be like a overlap based on your data. Here it's like 100%. But it's based on like how it's understanding. For example, if duck is understood as a cow, then you would be getting like the different things. Probably like I will show it in the different data set. I have the same AutoML vision built for identifying the different type of boards. You can see like the confusion matrix here, right? Sometimes the gondola is recognized as sailboat. Sometimes cruise is recognized as sailboat. So this is the confusion matrix. So you need to make sure like this blue rectangle that should be like the higher value. If the confusion matrix is getting higher value, then your model is not well-tuned or well-performed. So that's the most thing about the metrics. And once you have trained the model and evaluate the model, you can do the prediction here. And the prediction, you can upload the images, you can integrate with the REST API. For example, here, I'm in the boat. Okay, I'm in the boat model. I will upload the sailboat. So you can see like the prediction result is coming as sailboat that is 100% confident, right? Now back to that toys thing. Here I'm uploading the beer, the image of same thing here. And it's 99.8%. This toy is beer, right? So it's, since the machine learning is based on the accuracy, this accuracy may not be like exactly always greater than 90%. Based on the confusion matrix and based on like the different features, I have like a toy, which is the dog looks exactly like beer. So sometimes it's getting confused with that. And I have a frog toy that's getting confused with the duck toy. So it's like it's getting the confusion. So we need to add like more training images. If you have added like more than 1,000 labeled data sets, that would be like awesome. So once you have predicted, you can integrate with REST API and do all those stuff. Now back to that slide. So this one we talked about, right? Confusion matrix. Okay. Now let's talk about that. Like, okay, it's not machine learning is not only to identify cat and dogs or identify like a difference between toys or the simple classification. How we are going to implement this machine learning APIs and this AutoML to our real-time projects, right? So a couple of examples, like the same toys classification. Let us think about like how we can enhance this. For example, this Disney has like different characters, right? Disney has like Mickey, Minnie, Goofy, and they are having like a different character experience. And they can like develop this model using images with like different characters. And they can integrate the features into their application or something. Like, hey, if you get like, if you met all these characters, you'll be getting some badge or something. So if user uploads the image to their application, then the application can like train that. And the application detect like, okay, they have take the picture with these characters. And we are going to gamify that experience, right? Not only for that parks, you can say like the retail experience. So if I'm going to search for any jackets or coats, then I'm going to show the image, then it will identify all that related products. And those kind of product search experience and making sure like we are doing like emotional analysis on review. So there are like different areas we can improve the machine learning. And using this simple pre-trained ML APIs, that's a simple way to integrate slowly into our application. And based on our data, based on our data set, if we really want to build a custom model, then Google is providing like the TensorFlow, the open source machine learning model, and the Cloud ML engine to build the infrastructure, right? So these are the real use case, not only retail, like in energy, auto, finance, there are like a lot of use case available. So a couple of action items for you guys. So learn how the machine learns, right? So how machine is learning, probably I'm giving like the high level example, trying to identify that word versus with Apple. But try to understand like how machine learns and what are the different algorithms and what are the different steps it includes. And try this AutoML. And AutoML is like, it may look simple, like getting the data, upload it, and getting the prediction. But it's not like 100% successful, like I've seen, because it's based on the data we are owning. I cannot build like a high quality success model with these four toys in my home. But if I own the data, if I'm owning some toy store or something, then I have like a huge data set that's coming into my into my data systems, right? So based on that data, then I can build like a high quality training models. So try that AutoML and try TensorFlow. Try to understand like how TensorFlow works if you want to build your custom model. And also like there are a couple of links I have provided where it's giving like a open images data set. So try with this one. So if you go to this open images data set link, you are having like a enormous amount of images that contains the different domain also. For example, like a boat classification, even like the medical field in the scanned images, they are having like X-ray images that has like pneumonia or not. So you can get those data and try with this AutoML and see like how the AutoML performs with the more data. You can use like a Google Cloud Platform credit, the free credit. I think it's giving $300. So you can use that, and if you want, you can like try with the more than 1,000 images and see like how you can tune those parameters, because everything is done by AI, but still we are owning the data. So our data needs to be cleaned and pre-processed so that like it's giving that the better predictions. And the final thing is like, yeah, be kind and spread your awesomeness, kind to each other, and like help learning with each other, and better we together, like we will be very successful. And thank you.